Alright, we've covered Yennefer and Geralt's featurettes for the upcoming Witcher show on Netflix, so the only logical conclusion now is to go over the one about Ciri as well. This one is going to be a little weird. My Yennefer reaction was rather negative, and my Geralt reaction rather positive. Here I think I'll take more of a middle ground. In a similar way to Yennefer's featurette, the one about Ciri focuses almost entirely on her story before she finds Geralt, and in the books, that area is nearly unexplored. Instead, book Ciri has two main arcs, if I can call them this way. The first one starts when she meets Geralt, grows attached to him, goes to Kaer Morhen and trains with him and the other witchers, and also Triss, of course, who may or may not be mostly focused on getting inside Geralt's pants, but still, afterwards she trains with Yennefer and develops that relationship, for which I talked a bit about in the Yennefer featurette video, and finally culminates after the coup on Thanet. Through this whole time, she is a key character, but still not the main one, that of course being Geralt. Then the second arc begins immediately afterwards when she joins the Rats and goes on a whole new adventure of her own, meeting a ton of new characters and basically turning into the main character of the books herself. Now, how does her featurette fit in with all of this? Well, it could work fairly well, actually. I had issues with showing too much of Yennefer's backstory too early, but the case of Ciri is different. On the other hand, it's still worth posing the question of whether there's really a need for more content with Ciri in it, and it's because the books already have so much of her later on. Makes me wonder whether she'll overshadow Geralt too much, especially now that Yennefer is also going to be a very prominent figure from the start. Now, shall I go more specifically over what we see and hear in this featurette? Funny thing is that I actually had to consult with a fellow Witcher fan, whom you may have seen or heard of in my previous videos, namely Gaming Solves My Issues. She's an English lady, allegedly, and helped me make sure that I understand what exactly is being said in the trailer, because it's a little confusing. For example, this line sounds like, "as in life, is impossible," instead of, "as in life, it is impossible."
As in life, it is impossible always to be fully prepared for battle.
Then here she literally says, "people are after her" does become something very scary, instead of, "it does become something very scary."
"People are after her" does become something very scary.
And then there's this line from which I couldn't make out a single word.
"At least you didn't shit your cacks. At least you didn't shit your cacks."
Apparently, and once again thanks to Gaming Solves My Issues, the guy says, "at least you didn't shit your cacks." Meaning, at least you didn't shit your pants. Not sure exactly what he's referring to, perhaps the dancing proposal?
"That box.
Would you honor me with the dance?"
"Martin.
She'd love to."
Anyway, one particular part is very meaningful though, and it is this.
"A huge theme in The Witcher is the loss of family and the search for family."
That statement is very true. Probably not so much in general for all the characters, but very true for Ciri specifically. She has something initially and loses it, then meets Geralt and goes to Kaer Morhen, and those people become her family for a while, which is reinforced once again in the third game, with her calling Vesemir uncle and so on.
"You're smart. How do you know these things? Did your father teach you?"
"Not my father. My uncle. Uncle Vesemir."
She then leaves and forges a bond with Yennefer. She in turn starts calling Ciri daughter, so there's another family theme there, then they separate as well and she meets the Rats, and they sort of become her family after a couple of rape attempts, I suppose, and she loses that too, and so on. Anyway, so this line gives me a bit of hope that perhaps this young woman does understand Ciri and knows what she's doing, and I hope that's the case. What else can we talk about? I've already said that I like the way the actress looks. More or less, she's perhaps a bit too old to play little Ciri, who's supposed to be like 11 years old or something, but what can you do? I guess there's some issues with hiring way too young actors. Also, her eyes, while they are said to have a very particular and specific look in the books, look somewhat fake to me. It may just be in those close-up shots. There are other shots, actually, which I like. And in my opinion, she delivered her last line really well.
"This place isn't safe if you're alone.
And it's the same as every other place."
So, a bit of a mixed reaction to Ciri's trailer, definitely leaning a little towards the positive. And with that, I think we conclude our walkthrough of these featurettes, and leaves us with about a day, depending on your time zone, to find out everything for ourselves. I will definitely make more videos about the show, perhaps a review of sorts for each episode, can't say for sure yet. Also, the release of the show is on the very same day when my daughter's holiday break begins, so she'll be home all day, and couple that with the actual holidays, and I'll probably have to go see Star Wars and so on, so I won't have as much time for making videos as I would like, but I'll figure something out. So, I thank you very much for watching. Special thanks to my supporters on Patreon and the YouTube membership. Let me know what your thoughts are about series featurette, and have a wonderful time throughout the holidays with The Witcher Show, and hopefully with Star Wars. Meanwhile, until the next video, stay tuned and be good.